Christ is risen indeed. Good morning. I'm Pastor Mary Gilfett. I have been leading worship since Pastor Pam retired on April 6th and will continue through next Sunday, May 5th. A warm welcome to all of you worshiping in person or online with the worshiping community at Grace Lutheran Church in Lakeland, Florida. At this time, Dan Stoller has an announcement.
And again, another good morning. I have a short announcement in regards to peace. There is information in the bulletin to follow up. The peace meeting is Monday night, the biggest, most important event of the year. Special guest will be Mayor Mutz from Lakeland and from Winter Haven, Safety Director Byrd. The Executive Board of Peace will be pressing the issue of unnecessary arrests here in Polk County for first-time offenders. Like with Nehemiah, we need to show power with numbers. We need as many people there to show we care for one another. There is power in numbers. That's what we're looking for. A lot of people to show up. The information is in the bulletin. After the service, if you have any further questions, Tom, would you go ahead and wave? He's sitting in the back. He and myself are fairly knowledgeable of the upcoming meeting. If you have any further questions, we'll be glad to answer. Thank you.
Dan. The grace announcements are in the service folder insert. And then I'd like you to add someone to the prayer list, Doug Hedman. He's my brother-in-law. He's had several surgeries within the last week and needs prayers in recovery. Following worship, you're all invited for coffee fellowship. Today is the fifth Sunday of Easter. The image of Christ we'll read in the gospel for today is that of a vine. Christ is the vine, and we are the branches, abiding in him and bearing fruit for the life of the world. Let us prepare our hearts for worship. Please stand and face the baptismal font. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the wellspring of grace, our Easter and our joy. Amen. Look, here is water. Here is our water of life. Alleluia. Immersed in the promises of baptism, let us give thanks for what God has done for us. We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning your voice thundered over the deep, and water became the essence of life. Adam and Eve beheld Eden's verdant rivers. The ark carried your creation through the flood into a new day. Miriam led the dancing as your people passed through the sea into freedom's land. In a desert pool, the Ethiopian official entered your boundless baptismal life. Look, here is water. Here is our water of life. Hallelujah. At the river, your beloved son was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. By the baptism of Jesus' death and resurrection, you opened the floodgates of your reconciling love, freeing us to live as Easter people. We rejoice with glad hearts, giving all honor and praise to you through the risen Christ, our source of living water. In the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Amen. Look, here is water.
Here is our water of life. Hallelujah.
We'll sing our gathering hymn, and we'll all sing verses 1, 2, 4, and 5, and the choir will sing verse 3. The beauty of the Creator inspire us. The grace of the Good Shepherd be with us. And the unity of the breath of life enfold us all. May it be so. Let us pray. O God, you give us your Son as the vine, apart from whom we cannot live. Nourish our life in his resurrection, that we may bear the fruit of love and know the fullness of your joy. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Amen. Please be seated. At this time, I'm going to do a kids' time, and so I'll invite any kids to come forward, and a parent may come forward. And let's see, probably best to sit in this front row. I talked to them ahead of time. I asked, would you come forward? Because I know there was a mother and children last week. I talked to her about it. And so, anyway, you can just sit right up here. Oh, and more? Oh, good. And actually, all of us are children of God, so you can participate too, but I'll have special attention. Thanks for coming up. So, what do I have here? Fruit. Fruit, yeah, and what kind of fruit do I have here?
Oranges,
lime, lemons. Oranges, limes, lemons. Anything else?
Apple.
Grapes. Do you like fruit? Yeah, I really like fruit. It's one of my favorite things. Well, fruit, some fruit come from trees, and grapes come from vines. But the main thing I'm wanting to say here is that with a tree, there's a trunk. It'll stay. There's a trunk. And then there are branches that come from that trunk. And the branches then get the fruit off of them. Or if we were to look at like the grapes, there's a vine, and then there are branches, and then the grapes come off of that. But in any case, we'll get to Jesus. In our gospel text for today, Jesus said, I am the vine, and you are the branches, and you bear fruit. So, I don't see any of you bearing any oranges or grapes or apples, huh? What he meant was something different, that our fruit is something else. Our fruit is love, joy. You know it by heart. What are some of them? The fruit of the Spirit.
Love, joy, peace.
Patience, kindness, goodness. Faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Let's hear it for her. All right. Can any of you do that? Yes, from Galatians. It tells us what the fruit of the Spirit is. And when we're connected to the vine, do you know that verse too?
Yeah,
she knows it too. When we're connected to the vine and when we're baptized into Jesus, we're connected to Jesus, the vine. And we produce fruit. That's just how it is, because we're part of his vine, and it's the fruit that how Jesus would be when Jesus is on earth, or how God is. All that fruit is word like Jesus. Let's pray. Lord, we thank you that we're not on our own, that we're connected to you, that you're our vine, or you're our tree trunk, and that the fruit we produce is really you and your life and your love. So as we go forth from this place, we're grateful for the fruit that's produced in our lives so that others may know you. In Jesus' name, amen. So we'll sing the first verse of Jesus Loves Me. Do you want some fruit? Do you want any fruit? Do you want any fruits? Oh, you can, you want the...
Our first reading this morning is from the book of Acts, chapter 8. An angel of the Lord said to Philip, "Get up and go towards the south to the road that goes down from Jerusalem to Gaza. This is a wilderness road." So he got up and went. Now there was an Ethiopian eunuch, a court official of the Candace, queen of the Ethiopians, in charge of her entire treasury. He had come to Jerusalem to worship and was returning home. Seated in his chariot, he was reading the prophet Isaiah. Then the Spirit said to Philip, "Go over to the chariot and join it." So Philip ran up to it and heard him reading the prophet Isaiah. He asked, "Do you understand what you are reading?" He replied, "How can I unless someone guides me?" And he invited Philip to get in and sit beside him. Now the passage of the scripture that he was reading was this: "Like a sheep, he was led to slaughter, and like a lamb silent before its shearer, so he does not open his mouth. In his humiliation, justice was denied him. Who can describe his generation? For his life is taken away from the earth." The eunuch asked Philip, "About whom, may I ask you, does the prophet say this, about himself or about someone else?" Then Philip began to speak, and starting with his scripture, he proclaimed to him the good news about Jesus. As they were going along the road, they came to some water. And the eunuch said, "Look, here is water. What is to prevent me from being baptized?" He commanded the chariot to stop. And both of them, Philip and the eunuch, went down into the water. And Philip baptized him. When they came up out of the water, the Spirit of the Lord snatched Philip away. The eunuch saw him no more and went on his way rejoicing. But Philip found himself at Azotus. And as he was passing through the region, he proclaimed the good news to all the towns until he came to Caesarea. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us now read responsively the 22nd Psalm. From you comes my praise in the great assembly. I will perform my vows in the sight of those who fear the Lord.
The poor shall eat and be satisfied. Let those who seek the Lord make a praise. May your hearts live forever.
All the ends of the earth shall remember and turn to the Lord. All the families of the nations shall bow down before God. Indeed, all who sleep in the earth shall bow down in worship, and all who go down to the dust, though they be dead, shall kneel before the Lord.
Their descendants shall serve the Lord, whom they shall proclaim for generations to come.
They shall proclaim God's deliverance to the people yet unborn, saying to them, "The Lord has acted." Our second reading this morning is from the first book of John, chapter 4. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is from God. Everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love, God does not know God, for God is love. God's love was revealing among us in this way: God sent his only Son into the world so that we might live through him. In this is love, not that we love God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the atoning sacrifice for our sins. Beloved, since God loved us so much, we also ought to love one another. No one has ever seen God. If we love one another, God lives in us, and his love is perfected in us. By this we know that we abide in him and he in us, because he has given us of his Spirit. And we have seen and do testify that the Father has sent his Son as the Savior of the world. God abides in those who confess that Jesus is the Son of God, and they abide in God. So we have known and believe that love that God has for us. God is love, and those who abide in love abide in God, and God abides in them. Love has been perfected among us in this, that we may have boldness on the day of judgment, because as he is, so are we in this world. There is no fear in love, but perfect love casts out fear, for fear has to do with punishment, and whoever fears has not reached perfection in love. We love because he first loved us. Those who say, "I love God," and hate their brothers or sisters are liars. For those who do not love a brother or sister who they have seen cannot love God whom they have not seen. The commandment we have from him is this: those who love God must love their brothers and sisters also. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please rise as we welcome the gospel.
The Gospel according to John, the 15th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said, "I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine grower. He removes every branch in me that bears no fruit. Every branch that bears fruit, he prunes to make it bear more fruit. You have already been cleansed by the word that I have spoken to you. Abide in me, as I abide in you. Just as the branch cannot bear fruit by itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Those who abide in me and I in them bear much fruit, because apart from me, you can do nothing. Whoever does not abide in me is thrown away like a branch and withers. Such branches are gathered, thrown into the fire, and burned. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, ask for whatever you wish and it will be done for you. My Father is glorified by this, that you bear much fruit and become my disciples." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. You may be seated. Grace to you and peace from God our Creator and our Lord and Savior Jesus, who is the risen Christ. Amen. My father grew up in Bradenton, Florida. After he graduated from high school, his family moved to Tampa. There, my grandfather, who was a carpenter, built a triplex. After my grandfather died, my dad inherited the property. Since we lived out of state, Dad needed an overseer for the property. The overseers were not always dependable, so our family made a trip to Tampa every year to check on the property. Now, checking on the property did not just mean looking it over. It included fixing, scrubbing, painting, And my parents and we six kids would work tirelessly day and night for a week. The weather was usually hot, and the work seemed unending. But by the end of our week in Tampa, the property would look like new. As a reward for our work, each evening, Dad would take us to the beach or a sightseeing attraction. No matter where we went, though, it seemed like Florida was one big city. That was my impression when I was younger. However, when I became older, I found that Florida really is not one big city. It actually has a lot of country and farmland. Sebring, Florida, is farm country. The farming there is called muck farming, and that is because the land is proto-peat. Peat is usually found in wetlands, so it's all organic and shimmies like jello. Sebring has some huge peat fields that look like something from a science fiction movie. The fields are filled with tree stumps about 4 or 5 feet tall, cut off, and painted white. Those weird tree stumps are part of a citrus grove. The farmers grow lemon trees because they are the hardiest citrus fruit. And when the lemon trees get to a certain height, they cut them off, paint them white, and let them sit for a while, and then graft whatever fruit they want onto the lemon stumps. That means that grapefruit, orange, and tangerine branches are grafted on to the lemon stumps. The result is a hearty, abundant, delicious citrus crop of whatever was grafted on to the lemon stump. I think that's amazing. If the citrus branches had not been grafted onto the lemon stumps, there would not have been the abundance of fruit or the hearty quality of fruit. The person who is baptized into Christ is like a branch grafted onto Jesus, the vine. Those who are grafted onto the vine of Jesus produce abundant fruit. The Apostle Paul, in his letter to the Christians in Galatia, named the abundant fruit we produce: love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. When we're grafted into the vine of Jesus, when we abide in him, we love more. We have more peace, more patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. And the quality of our fruit, the quality of our love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control, the quality is genuine. It's hearty, colorful, full of flavor. The comedian and pianist Victor Borge once surprised his friends by purchasing a chicken farm. One of his friends asked him suspiciously, Do you know anything about breeding chickens? Borgi answered, no, but the chickens do. Yes, the chickens do. It comes naturally to them. And so also it comes naturally for branches on a vine to bear fruit. That is what the person grafted into Christ does without any prodding. We bear fruit naturally. And when we abide in Christ, the fruit of Christ comes naturally. We love. There's another interesting thing about grafting. You cannot graft an apple tree onto the lemon stumps. It must be citrus. The person who is grafted to the Lord is stuck loving. There is no other way to be or act. Otherwise, we become like dead branches, ready to be pruned. Every day our branches reach out to others with the fruit of Christ's Spirit, the fruit of love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. As we abide in the vine Jesus, our branches will be full of delicious fruit that will sustain us and all of our relationships until we see Jesus face to face. Let us take a few moments of silent prayer and reflection. Amen. Please stand and we'll sing the hymn of the day.
now we confess our Christian faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God.
Rejoicing that Jesus is risen and love has triumphed over fear, let us pray for the church, the world, and all those in need of good news.
Pray for the church around the world, for all ministers, and for the mission of the gospel. Keep all the newly baptized and confirmed in your care. Cleanse our hearts with your word of help, us to abide in you always. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
For the well-being of the earth and all created things, for rivers and lakes, streams and estuaries, melting glaciers and polluted waters. Renew the face of the earth and shower us with your goodness. God of grace, for the nations and all those in authority, for local, state, and national leaders, for elected representatives at every level, and for international organizations, that justice and peace may reign. God of grace, for all those in need, for any experiencing homelessness or unemployment, for those fleeing from oppression or seeking asylum, and for all who are ill or suffering. This morning we especially are praying for Sarah, Mary, Anne, Mabel, Mike, Anna May, Doris, Chuck, Anne, Julie, Carol, Tom, Lydia, Brian, Paul, Will, Amy, Bob and Jane, Mary, Scott, Ron and Flo, Carla, Monica, Avery, Jan, Irene, Doris, Dottie, John, Tim, Betty, Pastor Pam, Linda, Jeff, Henry, Gary, Mary, Greg, Sue, Helen and Ron, Doug, Max, and Lord, please be with the families and our heroes this morning of the Polk County Sheriff's Department. On Friday night, they answered the call and were seriously injured. Please be with them during this difficult and trying time. God of grace, for this congregation, for the caring ministers of this faith community, for all who visit and minister to one another, for all who take communion to homes or care centers, and for all who seek to share your love with the world, God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Go ahead. I'll do this one. With thanksgiving for saints who rest from their labors, Help us, like them, to bear much fruit and to become your disciples. And at the last, bring us to that heavenly banquet where all will feast together at your table. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Into your hands, most merciful God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your abiding love through Jesus Christ, our resurrected and living Lord. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us share God's peace with one another. You may be seated. We prepare now to receive our offerings as we return to God a portion of what God has entrusted to us.
Oh,
Let us pray. Whatever we ask in accordance with your will, we receive and our cup overflows. Confident in divine abundance and humbly eager to turn from covetous greed, we return what we have received for the shepherd's work, that green pastures and safe folds will welcome any who live in fear, that peaceful waters will sustain hurting hearts, that a voice of welcome will be heard at each gate, that a feast will be prepared for all who hunger and thirst, and all may safely graze. In the name of the one who is our comfort, amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Let us pray together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Please be seated. All baptized children of God are invited to the Lord's table. We'll commune at the head of the aisle, where you'll receive the host, and then on either side will be the trays of wine and grape juice. The risen Christ is made known to us in the breaking of the bread. Come and eat at God's table.
Thank you.
Beautiful Savior.
Jesus is Lord.
Please stand. The body and blood of our risen Lord Jesus Christ strengthen us and keep us in his grace unto life everlasting. Amen.
One moment. Shepherding God, you have prepared a table before us and nourished us with your love. Send us forth from this banquet to proclaim your goodness and share the abundant mercy of Jesus, our Redeemer and friend. Amen.
Let us sing our sending hymn, one of my favorites. Receive the benediction. Little children, sheep of the Good Shepherd, as we journey toward the fold, we travel through the valley of shadow, growing in grace, becoming a blessing. Baptismal wells restore our souls. A rich feast is spread by divine abundance, and divisions end as our cup overflows. Amen.
Go in peace. Journey gently on this planet's green pasture.
Thanks be to God.